Hi everyone, it's Becky from lifetimehub.com and I'm here today with Paula, and she's going to be talking to us about her own journey on coming out and being okay with kind of accepting and telling the world that she is gay. So first, just kind of give everyone a little bit of background, you know, wherever you want to start on the journey. Would it be very early?
Would I have known I was gay very early?
Like as a child?
Yeah, I think I would have, but I also... I think mine would have been more complicated because of the abuse.
Right.
So because I was abused,
her father abused her.
Even when I knew I was gay, I thought it was as a result of the abuse, not necessarily. It probably took me longer to accept that I was gay because of the abuse.
Oh.
It probably wouldn't have taken me as... Maybe it would have, but I don't think it would have taken me as long.
Right.
To accept it.
Right.
If I wasn't always playing games in my head thinking...
It was just, so
I had issues with men because of my father.
So you thought, I'm not really gay, it's just because my dad abused me.
Yeah.
Oh.
So I would have been very, and also because I internalized everything, I didn't at the time talk to anybody.
Right.
So any conversations I had were in my head, I never verbalized it with anybody.
Oh, okay.
So, and it wasn't, and believe it or not, my sexuality didn't come out to my friends.
Right.
Until the abuse came out.
So how old would you have been about?
25.
Wow.
So even though I had been in a relationship since I was 18, I didn't come out to friends.
Okay.
Or family.
Okay.
Until the abuse was out. Which
okay.
made life very difficult.
I'm sure. So when you were 18 and you first had that relationship with a woman, you were still struggling and you still didn't know if maybe it was from...
Yeah, I was. And in every relationship I've had, because I never made a move on anybody, I wouldn't have had the confidence because... The first woman I had a relationship with was much older than me, and because she made the move on me, I still wasn't convinced.
Oh, okay.
It wasn't because she was a woman, it was because she was interested.
Oh, okay.
So that would have complicated
right.
how I felt.
Right.
Because I still wasn't convinced I was gay. Because I didn't fancy every woman. And I always thought if you were gay, you fancied women. And I didn't. I hung around with girls, I wasn't interested in any of them.
Okay.
So that would have added a little bit. That's what makes it confusing.
Yeah.
Because the stereotypical thing that when people talk about gay women or gay men,
yeah.
immediately it's like they fancy everybody that yeah. have the same sex.
Yeah. So which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
Because straight people aren't like that either.
I know.
Yeah.
But when you're gay and you're... and I was also convinced there was something seriously wrong with me because of the abuse. So then when I figured out I was gay, I was thinking that's another deficit in my character. I didn't see it as a good thing.
Oh.
I'd never seen it as a positive.
Oh.
It was always, there was something seriously wrong with me.
Wow.
What was wrong with me?
So you really beat yourself up about it?
Yeah.
Wow.
And it took a long, long, long time before I realised actually that was okay to be gay.
Okay. And even now, would you say, are you comfortable?
Oh, now, yeah, now I would be.
Okay.
And it's taken a long time.
Yeah.
Like I'm 48 now, so it's taken that long
okay.
for me to go, okay, it's okay to be.
And was that a process?
Yes.
Or did something happen?
No, it was a process. It was a process. It was having a lot of bad relationships.
Okay.
Getting in for a relationship. And like straight people, I got into relationships with my own baggage.
Mm.
But I wouldn't have been aware that I had baggage.
Okay.
So, and then some of the relationships I had were with women who had children who had previously been married. I didn't have a relationship with anybody who was out.
Mm.
My first relationship for 7 years was with a woman who wasn't out. And I swear to this day, she's still not out. Because some people have bigger issues.
Yeah.
Other women I was with, because they had children, obviously weren't out. Didn't want to be out.
Oh.
So to me, it was another secret.
Yeah.
So, and because it was a secret, then why wouldn't I think there was something seriously wrong with it?
Right.
And something seriously wrong with me.
Right.
So, when I met Siobhan, who's my current partner, who I'm with 14 years now, she was married.
Okay.
So again,
to
it was a
man.
Complication.
Yeah.
yeah. So then it was about, as soon as she was okay with that, then it made it okay for me to be okay and out.
So your partner being okay with being out is what led you to be okay?
Well,
with
it helped. It absolutely helped. Now, I was out before I met Siobhan. I was way out before I met Siobhan. But that definitely...
Or you mean...
Just out. Like, see, there's a difference. I had... All my friends at that stage knew I was gay because I had... said I was gay.
Right.
But if I was out in company and I was with somebody that I was with, I would sit at the other end of the room. I certainly wouldn't hold hands and I wouldn't be touchy-feely or kissy
really?
Or anything.
Really? Okay.
Because I still, even though my friends had no issues with me being gay, as far as The one thing I hate is somebody saying, we don't have a problem with this, or we accept you. I'm thinking, shag off, I don't care. I find that really insulting.
Oh, because they think they have to acknowledge
it. I accept you because you're straight.
Yeah.
So why do they accept me because I'm gay?
Absolutely.
So why would that statement even come into it?
Right.
So I had lots of issues around that. And then when I was with somebody and I was physically sitting talking to somebody, then people who told me they had no issues had huge issues.
Oh.
I turned up to an event one time, and I was very into basketball, and I turned up to an event one time where a girl I was going out with, and she was very out, she was very demonstrative.
Okay.
But it caused a row. Because people were, she went into the toilet at one stage and there was other girls in the toilet having a conversation, not realising she was in
the cubicle. Okay, yeah.
So they were having a conversation outside saying how disgraceful it was and how sick it was. And you know, these were people who, up to the time this happened, I would have thought there wasn't an issue.
Wow.
There absolutely wasn't an issue, because to my face, nobody had an issue.
Mm.
So that kind of caused a lot of problems. And people
absolutely
said, a few of the comments that night were a best friend, and I mean a best male friend of mine, told me I should control myself in public, that I shouldn't be flying the flagpole for gay rights, who did I think I was?
Wow.
And that if I didn't want anybody to have an issue with me, then I shouldn't be doing that in public.
Wow.
So that was the kind of
And how long ago was this?
It would have been before I met Siobhan, so it was probably about 15, 16 years ago.
Wow.
And also when I was discovering that I was gay and I wanted to live a gay lifestyle, there was no gay icons.
Oh, okay.
There was no out gay people.
Yeah.
There was no celebrities that were willing to say they were gay. There was
I'm a lesbian or I'm proud.
Well, there was a tennis player who looked like a man. There's that stereotype of, and I remember the very first gay bar I ever went into. I remember walking in the door and thinking, I will never go into a gay bar again. Because when I walked in the door, it was like a long, skinny, narrow bar.
Yeah.
And lots of the women, there was women kind of on both sides of this long table. It was a normal standard bar, but on half of the side of the table, women had very short haircuts, very short. And on the other side, women had long haircuts. And I just thought, oh, the stereotype that you're told about.
Yeah.
I thought, oh my God, I don't fit into either of those. Okay. I'm not the femme type,
right.
And I'm not the butch type.
Right.
So where do I fit? Well, and I didn't particularly want to fit into either of them.
Mm.
So I would have really struggled with that. And it was quite a few years before I went back into a gay bar after that.
Really?
Yeah, it really impacted me, because I was thinking, and there's nothing worse than somebody categorising you and labelling you and telling you are something, when I kind of felt I didn't fit into any of them.
Yeah. So you think today teenagers maybe would be luckier
because there's gay luckier.
Yeah.
And also if you go into a gay bar today, it is women and men in it. It's still very male orientated.
Yeah.
But the young girls now who are out are very confident, very sexy, very themselves. They're not either swinging one way or the other. Like, they're not dressing like a man because they discovered they're gay. They're wherever they are, they are, and they're comfortable in it.
Right.
You know?
Well, in some places, but what about someone who's watching this and they might live in a small town that's maybe very religious or whatnot, and they're being bullied or they don't feel that they can be out? You know, is there anything you could say to them?
Move.
I know, really. It's okay. It's not like that everywhere.
Move.
Like, how long before you said, oh, I think there's something wrong with me, and you beat yourself up about it. How long before that stopped? Or is there something you could say to someone to do so that they stop beating themselves up and realize it's okay to just be yourself?
I think that's a really difficult one, because I think when you're gay, you will always have, and see, I think the difference with me is because when you're abused and you're gay, you will always have a little thing in the back of your mind thinking, am I, haven't I?
And you still have that?
Well, no, I would be, like, there's times when I have absolutely no issues being gay.
Yeah.
But there will always be that niggly thing in the back going, was it just because I had such a bad experience?
Mm.
No, and it wasn't that I didn't experiment with men equally.
Right.
Because I so did. Not in a good way, but I did.
Okay.
And I have really good, solid male friends.
Okay.
So it's just, the problem with it is it's complicated. How do you get comfortable with it? It's not about other people, that's how you get comfortable with it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about either trying to please or not please somebody around you. It's about being comfortable with who you are. And when you're comfortable with who you are, nothing else matters. And having support and having people around you who don't care who your partner is, And I think the problem with gay people is when you have issues with your partner, when you have the normal issues that a straight couple have,
right,
you're more limited in who you can talk to about it. Because you assume, people assume two women together would not have the same issues as a man and a woman together.
Right.
Because you're supposed to understand each other better and because you can see things from a woman's point of view.
Right.
It can actually increase the problems between two women. Right. Because you're both emotional.
Yeah.
You're both sensitive.
Yeah.
It's not like a guy saying, I'm not really sure, can I tell her she looks good in that outfit or not. It's exactly the same with two women.
Yeah.
You still have to think about,
yeah,
managing how you deal with another person. It's right. All about compromise. It's right. All about... It's all about being sensitive to somebody else and still being true to yourself.
Right.
And that is, it doesn't matter whether you're straight or gay.
Yeah.
But when you're gay, you're convinced, because the society around you tells you, well, obviously two women are not going to have the same issues about who does the dishes. Absolutely you do.
Yeah.
Who does the iron? Absolutely you do.
Yeah.
And did you ring me when you should have? Do you care? You have the same issues across the board. But when you're gay, I think you're limited in being able to discuss that.
With your friends?
Yeah.
Okay.
And because you feel, I think that the hardest thing when you're a teenager or when you're in that early stage when you're coming out is 90% of your friend set will be straight.
Right.
So how do you discuss it with your friend set when they don't get you?
Right.
Or when because of society, they're thinking, will people assume they're gay as well? Like I know when I came out to my friends, some of our friends had real issues around other people thinking they were also gay.
What?
Because they were with me. So if I was gay, are you, like if I'm sitting in a pub with you and we're having a chat but I happen to touch you and all that, I know some of my friends had issues thinking other people would think they were gay and they didn't want to be labelled gay.
Oh, okay.
So it's about
people. So you definitely, or not definitely, but you might lose friends or people you think are your friends.
And that's it. Because mm-hmm. if they have a problem with it, and it's the only people who do not have a problem with you being gay are people who are sound about their own sexuality, right. And then it doesn't matter.
Right.
But if people are not sound about their own sexuality, in my opinion,
yeah.
then they have issues around whether you're gay or straight or
yeah.
it doesn't make any difference.
Right. See that, everyone? It's something they're wrestling with.
That's it.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that is it. Because if you're okay with who you are,
yeah.
why would you not be okay with somebody else?
Absolutely. Or caring what a stranger thinks of you,
yeah.
sitting with someone. Absolutely.
It is. It's all about going inside and sorting you out.
Yeah.
Because then the rest actually doesn't matter. And you will only attract and be around people who are true and
right.
friends.
Right.
And it's not about people accepting you, because I really hate that. That's crap.
Yeah.
It's not about being accepted. It's about people accepting you for who you are.
Like you're just a person.
Your friend.
Yeah.
I'm your friend, I'm your sister, I'm your yeah. whatever.
Yeah.
And it doesn't make any difference if I'm gay or straight. I'm either a good person or I'm not.
Right.
So my sexuality actually is that much
yeah.
compared to the rest of me.
Okay.
But when you're gay, your sexuality becomes that much.
That's so
compared
true.
Compared to the rest of you.
Yeah, that's so true.
Because everybody else sees your sexuality before they see who you are.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of people who are gay, in lots of cases, won't come out and say, like when I went to college as a mature student, I didn't have a problem being out at that stage, but I didn't tell people in my class I was gay at the beginning because I wanted them to get to know me first.
Mm.
And then if they have issues around my gay, they've already known me.
Right.
So in lots of cases, I wouldn't recommend you come straight out and say you're gay, and not for any other reason other than you need people to know you before that's not an issue.
Right.
Whereas if you don't walk into a room when you meet a group of people and say immediately, oh, by the way, I'm straight.
Right.
And expect a group of people not to have issues with
yeah.
that. I'd be thinking, why are you telling me
or
that?
Feel you have to acknowledge to people what
yeah,
your well, sexual preference
yeah,
is.
You get to know people first, and then
yeah.
if it's a conversation, it's not about hiding it, and it's not about saying I'm ashamed of this. It's simply about, does it matter in
yeah.
the big scheme of things?
Yeah.
I'm here as a student, or I'm here as a this, or I'm a colleague.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter who I spend my life with.
So what I'm getting from you, for someone who's maybe out there watching this that is struggling with thinking about coming out or not knowing are they gay or are they not gay, is it sounds like it took you time. It was a long journey. It's a process. And to make, well, you did say, you know, depending on the situation, either you don't have to lead with it every time.
No,
and
why would
feel
you?
Like you have to.
Yeah.
But if you want to, you might lose friends, but they're not friends anyway, and
yeah.
and just focus on.
Well, you see, I would actually explore why somebody has issues with it.
Yeah.
I think the most important thing for any gay person is to realise if somebody has an issue, it is their issue, not your issue.
Absolutely.
But it's really difficult when you're younger to realise that the issues are somebody else's, they're
yeah.
not yours.
Yeah.
because they are somebody else's.
Because society.
But you're so insecure and you're so lacking in confidence, you assume that it's your problem when it really isn't.
Yeah.
It's their stuff. Let them deal with it.
Absolutely. So any other advice for someone who's struggling with this right now?
I think it's like anything, and it doesn't matter what you are, who you are, the most important thing you'll ever do in your life is like yourself.
Mm.
Then the rest is irrelevant.
Right.
And the rest of your journey is easier if you can find anything in yourself that you like.
Yeah.
And realise that your sexuality is part of you, not all of you.
Absolutely. Very good. That's so true.
That's good.
And here you are today, happy, you're in a relationship,
yeah.
You're open. You love yourself.
Oh, absolutely.
You lost those assholes back there that weren't your real friends.
Yeah, and that's it. You just have to say it's not worth it.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, thank you very much, Paula.
You're very welcome.